Peace be with you, and welcome to the Redemptorist Novena. We are glad we have something in common with you, which is our love for Mary and making her known. Let's begin with this hymn, Christ Be Our Light. Let us begin by invoking the Trinity, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, we are grateful to God for the many blessings we have received from Him through the prayers of our Mother of Perpetual Help. Let us once more ask her to pray with us and for us. We turn our eyes to Mary as Comforter of the Afflicted, one of the ancient titles in the Litany of the Blessed Virgin Mary, which originated in the Shrine Basilica of the Holy House of Loreto. Mary became the consoler of the afflicted, for she herself experienced affliction by enduring the sufferings of being the Mother of God in collaboration to God's plan of salvation. As we just launched the Protect Our Earth, Protect Our Children campaign, we bring to Mary vulnerable children from around the world who are afflicted with deadly diseases and illnesses. We wish to highlight some of these illnesses common among the most vulnerable children. Pneumonia. Pneumonia is one of the leading infectious diseases that causes death among children under 5, killing approximately 800,000 children a year. Child deaths caused by pneumonia are strongly linked to undernutrition, lack of safe water and sanitation, indoor air pollution, and inadequate access of health care. For these vulnerable children, we pray,
be with us, O loving Mother.
Polio. We also lift up children afflicted with the polio virus. It is a disabling and life-threatening disease caused by the polio virus. The virus spreads from person to person and can infect a person's spinal cord, causing paralysis in children. They cause muscle weakness that can affect the heart, breathing, and limb muscles, all of which cause disability and compromise the quality of a child's life. We pray for the eradication of polio around the world. For this, we pray.
Be with us, O loving Mother.
Tuberculosis was once a leading cause of death among children. We pray for healing for children around the world undergoing treatment, especially those in poorer countries. In parts of Asia and Africa, TB is one of the major childhood diseases. 1 million children per year contract TB, according to the World Health Organization estimates, and more than 230,000 of them die from it. We ask for healing and Mother Mary's protection for all these children. For them, we pray.
Be with us, O loving Mother.
Tetanus. We pray especially for children in poorer countries that have no footwear and are exposed to the danger of the tetanus bacteria. Tetanus is an acute, sometimes fatal disease of the central nervous system caused by the toxin of the tetanus bacterium, which usually enters the body through an open wound. We pray for greater awareness among adults, parents and guardians who have children under their care. For this, we pray.
Be with us, O loving Mother.
Let us pray a prayer for all sick children who have health issues and suffer anxiety and trauma. Loving Father, thank you that when your Son graced the earth, He welcomed the children and blessed them. Thank you that the same power that raised Him from the dead is at work for all children we now pray for. We invite you to come by the power of your Holy Spirit and restore these children so that they can enjoy the fullness of life. Bring your healing and strengthen them. Thank you for hearing our prayers. Hold the suffering children in the palm of your hands now and always. We make this prayer through the intercession of Mary, Comforter of the Afflicted. Amen. It's now time for your letters of petition and thanksgiving that have come into our website. Dear Mother, I seek your help. Please calm me and let me be at peace. I just lost my husband. The pain inside me is like a flaming, burning inside. The beautiful memories I have about my husband is making me cry every day. He was a wonderful husband and a loving dad to my children. May he rest in peace. Amen. Mother Mary, I am in a highly stressful job where small mistakes can blow out of proportion. I also work in an environment which is highly political. I seek your intercession for me that I will always be righteous in how I do my work and how I deal with my colleagues. I also pray for all those working with me, that they will always be guided by our conscience and will not put self-interest above all things. Thank you, Mother Mary. Dearest Mother Mary, please pray for my children who have wandered away from faith. I am deeply concerned for the welfare and the salvation of their souls and pray for their conversion and the return to the Catholic Church. Please keep them under your mantle and of your protection and guide them back to your Son Jesus. Have them to be steadfast in faith and always cling to you in prayer. Dearest Mary, I humbly ask you to help my daughter to pass her recent medical examination as she felt demoralized after sitting for it. She studied so hard and sacrificed a lot of her time for her family. Please also, dear Mother, I humbly ask you to help. I ask you help for my son to have good working relationships with his superiors and office colleagues. He is frustrated.
Please help him. Thank you, Mother, for interceding for them. Your humble servant. Dear Mother Mary, my elderly mother is going for a ballooning surgery at her veins. Please intercede that the doctors would be able to do the surgery. May my mother receive the correct medical attention from your grateful daughter. Dearest Mother, thank you so much for being a devoted mother to me and my family all these years. Mother, I pray for good health for my husband and myself as we are in our 60s and our health issues are the heart, blood pressure, cholesterol, and I'm recovering from cancer. Bring my daughter back to Mass in the Catholic faith. I pray for my mum who will be 90 this year. Please grant her good health. Please keep my family safe as we are in the vulnerable group. We remain your faithful children. Dearest Mother Mary, I'm making a very humble request to help heal my wife's pain that she has been facing so much trouble with. I pray that you will help her to do well again from your grateful son. Dear Mary, please help me to pray and intercede that our son's application to extend 3 more months working in NS is accepted, approved and successful. Thank you from your grateful daughter. Thanksgiving letters. Thank you, Mother Mary, for looking out for me. I am in a situation that is not ideal, but I feel this is where God wants me to be. Nevertheless, I feel at peace in my heart, in spite of the stresses I am surrounded by. Thank you for interceding for me to your son, as I do feel covered by your precious blood from your grateful child. Dearest Mother Mary, sorry for this overdue letter. I strongly believe you are always by my side each day of my life. And I'm now in my senior years. I wish to tell everyone that you have been a wonderful mother to me and your beloved son has been blessing my family all along in our ups and downs in life. Thank you, precious mother, from your loving child. Let us now continue with the prayer of confidence together.
Mother of perpetual help, we come to you and place our trust in you. You are a mother of mercy. You are called by all the refuge and the hope of sinners. Be then our refuge and our hope. Help us for the love of Jesus Christ. Stretch out your hand to us poor sinners. We bless and thank God for giving us this confidence in you. In the past, we have so often sinned, but with your help, we can conquer, and you will help us if we pray to you. In all our temptations, may we always turn to you and say, Mary, help me. Let me never lose my God. Amen. Let us share with Mary a prayer of praise and thanksgiving to God. My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. He looks on his servant in her nothingness. Henceforth all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty works marvels for me. Holy is his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in strength and scatters the proud-hearted. He casts the mighty from their thrones and raises the lowly. He fills the starving with good things, sends the rich away empty. He protects Israel his servant, remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. Mary, you are the mother of Christ.
And you are our mother also.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you with all our heart for giving us Mary to be our mother. She's so loving, so thoughtful, so understanding, and so kind. We thank you for her. Amen.
It's truly a beautiful day today, so we offer this him to Mary on this day, O beautiful Mother.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, welcome to our novena. The theme of our reflection today is Comfort the Afflicted. I would like to start our reflection today with a story. The last mission, December 2019, before the COVID-19 pandemic broke out, our mission team did one mission in one of the outstation, which about 70 kilometers from my place. As usual, we visited the families, the people from house to house and share, talk and pray together with them. Listening to their stories requires open-heartedness. Since we priests who come there, it doesn't mean that people in the villages would tell directly about their challenges to their faith. They wouldn't. And not at all. That is nothing to do with God. What happened was they spoke about their struggles to send their children to school, the drought that hit, the difficulties of having proper clothes, and the problem of hygiene, such as difficulties of getting a clean water. The kids around look dirty. It seems that they haven't showered for several days. Likewise, their parents. We saw all these things and we listened to their story as well. Eventually, we asked about where they can collect clean water for drinking, for washing, bathing. Then they were taken to the spring. To our surprise, we found that the spring was quite big and flowing. It's a kind of a stream they have there. In this place, families and animals bathe together and they use the same water. Unfortunately, the water was clogged and didn't flow smoothly due to garbage, a lot of dump there. Then we agreed to go down in groups and we cleaned the trash. We cleaned all the garbage, leaves and wood that blocked the waterway. So all must be dirty hands. As a result, the spring and rivers become clean. The water become flowing and smooth again. And the availability of clean water is sufficient. Even though they still have to walk 2 kilometers. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, dealing with difficulties and stressful situations, it could be experience of each individual. Even we in our community, I think we all have been there, even though the gradations are different. In such situation, one must not fold their hands. Our calling as disciple of Christ the Redeemer should be lived out. As disciples, we have the same role as Jesus himself says in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 4, verses 18 to 19. The Spirit of God is on me. Therefore, he anointed me to deliver the good news to the poor. And he has sent me to proclaim liberation for the captives and vision for the blind, to free the oppressed, to proclaim the year of God's grace has come. Brothers and sisters, our role is to be the comforter afflicted. That is the mission of Christ, which is our mission too. We should take part in lightening the lives of others. When we are involved in lightening the lives of others, blessing comes down to us too. We also can learn of Mary's willingness to accept her assignment as Mother of God. Her willingness is the willingness to get involved. She was not just there to listen. Mary did not present there in silent, not doing anything. Mary was there and moved as she took part in Elizabeth's life. She was also present in the life of the fearful apostles. The presence gave them a sense of comfort. The presence of Mary also provided direction through her attitude of faith. She dared to take the risk to make life as a blessing. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, now we are once again invited to share in the life and mission of Jesus the Redeemer and His Mother Mary. Let us make ourselves available always to share in the mission of Christ willingly and readily like His Mother, to be a comforter to the oppressed, the needy, the afflicted, wherever we are. God bless.
Prayer for the sick. Lord Jesus Christ, you bore our sufferings and carried our sorrows. Hear our prayers for the sick. Help them to unite themselves with your sufferings. And if it is your will, may they get better. Let them never forget that you care for them. Amen. Let us now pray for the intentions of our Holy Father, Pope Francis. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us, sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Mary, from thy sacred image, with those eyes so sadly sweet, Mother of perpetual succor, see us kneeling at thy feet. Child thou bearest, source of all thy joy and woe. What thy bliss, how deep thy sorrow. Mother, thou alone canst know. On thy face he is not gazing, nor on us is turned his glance. For his anxious look he fixes on the cross and reed and lance.
Given them bread from heaven.
Heaven itself, our delight.
Let us pray. O God, in this wonderful sacrament, you have left us a memorial of your passion. We ask you to enable us so to worship the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may constantly feel in our lives the effects of your redemption. You who live and reign forever and ever.
Blessed be God, blessed be His holy name, blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man, blessed be the name of Jesus, blessed be His most sacred heart, blessed be His most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious Assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in His angels and in His saints. Amen.
Once again, thank you very much for tuning in, for subscribing, and for giving us such wonderful support for this novena. As you know, we come from Ipoh, and I know that the viewers come from all around the world. A very special thank you to my confrère that worked with me at the church by the river. I was with him for about 4 or 5 years. We worked so closely together. It was a wonderful experience. And thank you, Father Willy Ngongopala, for sharing your reflections. We continue to pray for the world that's going through this pandemic. And so next week, we're going to return once again to the USA, to America. We have an amazing preacher for you. So please tune in. We will welcome next week, Daniel Francis. Let's end this novena with another very popular song during my time, a song made popular by the Hollies. He ain't heavy, he's my brother. See you next week.
The road is long, with a many a winding tongue that leads us to who knows where. It's a long, long road, from which there is no return. While we're on the way to there, why not share? He's my brother.